My name is Rex Mhiripiri. You'll be amazed at how many angles from which people pronounce my last name. I am married to Julie, a girl from Albert Lee, Minnesota. We own Mhiripiri Gallery in Bloomington, and we have owned this gallery since 1986.
My first interaction with the Mhiripiri Gallery was actually in the mid-1980s. I was a high school student working downtown, and he had a storefront on Nicollet Avenue. And I wandered into that shop and was just blown away. I'd never seen anything like that. I'd never seen artwork like that. It stuck with me.
At the major intersection of Penn and 90th became a disused gas station. Property went up for sale. We decided it was time to quit renting. We bought the place, so I started designing this gallery. We got an architect to put it into code and moved into our location here in 2005.
I honestly don't know of any for-profit gallery that is owned by the actual curator and artist.
We stand on what I am going to call three legs. Paintings by yours truly, Rex Mhiripiri, masks from many countries in Africa, and our mainstay, stone sculpture by artists in Zimbabwe.
He doesn't just find these works online and ship them. He actually has relationships with these artists and goes out to see them in their homes in Zimbabwe, in their studios, and develops that relationship.
Some of the artists we carry have exhibited at the Museum of Modern Art in New York, the Rodin in France, the Institute of Contemporary Art in London.
Zimbabwe Shona stone sculpture is so unique. There's nothing quite like that anywhere else.
They'll have quite an experience when they do come. Some people actually think it's a museum.
I am 86 now. I like to brag about that. And my life is complicated, convoluted. I grew up in the British colony of Zimbabwe. I lived in many countries. I lived in Canada and Kenya and Uganda and Zambia. And I traveled all over the map in Europe. I came to the U of M here. That's where I met my wife, Julie. We got to know each other in 1966, and we are still playing Scrabble today together. She does the unseen to get the gallery going, and I do the seen to get the gallery going, and together we are a pretty good match. It has worked. I don't like to work for other people, and I refuse to be a starving artist, and I am going to say the Lord God gave me the talent to paint, and I committed my life to painting pictures for a living.
He never did take an art class.
Because of that, the art that he creates is so naturally inspired. He really brings his heart and soul to the artwork that he creates. I think that the Mhiripiri Gallery and really the Mhiripiri family and Rex himself are really iconic in Bloomington. We're very lucky to have them.
And we have always felt and we have always known that Bloomington has been kind to us, and Bloomington is not buildings, it's the people, it's the citizens of this city. And for the record, I would like them to know that we are full of gratitude for the manner in which they received us as a gallery. They received me as a black man, and I have been blessed to live and work in this town.